Before we try to take a look at how to write the logic for the next problem, I would like to show you the syntax or the skeleton diagram of one more repeating or looping or repetition construct in algorithms. So what this does is, it says repeat for count starting from 1 to n. What it's actually doing here is, based on the value of n, it is going to execute this block n number of times. Suppose n is 5, these statements are going to be repeatedly executed 5 number of times. Count will always start from 1 in this case, and it will increase by 1 and go to n. You can also increase by 2, you can increase by 3, and so on. It's up to you. This is the count up loop. Now you can have a countdown also. So in the countdown, what I am doing is, I am starting from n all the way till say till 0. Since I am starting from n, n minus 1, n minus 2, and I am reaching 0, it will execute one time more than this one, because I want to execute it till it is 0. Suppose n is 5, this block is going to execute or repeat 6 number of times. So this is the syntax of a repeat for count. Quite simple, we'll be using it in this particular problem. Now, let's try to first understand what this problem is before we head to draw the logic. So, in order to understand this particular problem, let's read the definition. If you see here, it is saying, write an algorithm to find the sum of the series of this series 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9 all the way till the n for the first 30 terms. First thing you need to understand, what is this series? This is a series which is generating odd numbers, because the gap between each number happens to be 2, and the first number is 1, 3, 5, 7, and so on. So if you look at this 1 to n, this fellow is called as the first term. This is the second term, third term, fourth term. This is the nth term. So each of these individual fellows or numbers are called as terms. So what he is trying to tell you is, calculate the sum of the series for the first 30 terms. That means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Continue till you reach 30 terms. The 30th term is going to be the number 59. So what we are going to do is, in order to find the sum of the first 30 terms, I need one variable called as sum to store the sum of 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 all the way till the first 30 terms. Then my first number is 1. So what I am going to do in this loop is, I am going to take sum and add it to number, and after that I am going to increase number by not 1 but by 2, and this process I am going to do it 30 times, taking number, adding it to sum, and increasing number by 2. I am going to do it 30 times. Since I know the number of times I am going to do it, the best loop to be used for that is the repeat for count is 1 to 30. So what with this repeat for count is 1 to 30 will do is, this block of statements, these two, will get executed 30 times. So when it count is 1, this will get once. Count is 2, this will happen the second time. Till count is 30, it will do 30 times. Then finally, after that, step number 3, it will say sum of the 30 terms series is sum. Alright. So this should give you the sum of the first 30 terms. Now, what we are going to do here is, we are going to test this logic. Number is 1, sum is 0. Step number 1. Here on the left side, I have shown you count. So when count is 1, sum is 0 plus 1, it is 1. Number becomes 3. I go back here. For when count is 2, okay, number has become 1 plus, okay, number, now number has still remained 3. First sum is 1 plus 3 is 4. Number is, okay, 3 plus 2 is 5 at this step. Then when count is 3, first what happens is, this plus this, 4 plus 5, 9, sum becomes 9. then number becomes 5 plus 2, it becomes 7. So this process will keep repeating till count reaches 30 terms. The minute count reaches 30 terms here, it is going to print the result of sum. So I hope this helps you understand how to use the repeat for count logic or the repeat for count repetition or looping logic to develop an algorithm.